Hey everyone, this is Viren and welcome back to another Google Analytics tutorial. In this tutorial, we are going to cover the behavior reports in Google Analytics. To give you an overview, what the behavior reports do is they give you an understanding of how the user is behaving with regards to your content on the website. So it'll give you an overview of the page views, unique page views, how much time they spend on the page, the bounce rate and the exit percentage. It'll tell you how they are behaving with the content of your site. Are they searching on your site, the pages and things like that. So let's go into all the reports in detail so that we can cover each of these. First things first is a behavior flow. Now this is a very interesting graph, very interesting flow chart where Google shows you how the user flows through the different content of your site, where it drops off, so that when you know that this page has the most amount of drop off, you should work on this page to make sure that the users don't drop there from your site. If you go under site content, all pages, it will show you all the pages of your site, their links and how users are behaving on the site. On these pages, is the bounce rate too high or is the exit percentage too high? Then you probably need to work more on those pages. You can change the primary dimension to page title to make this more easily readable to you. Content drill down makes it easier to read the all pages report. What it does is it groups all the pages of your website by the folder they are in. So if Google Plus redesign is a folder, when you click on this folder, all the pages inside this folder will start showing up, or if there are more folders inside it, that will start showing up. You can check out all the landing pages where people land when they're coming to your site. Naturally, the home page would probably have most amount of landings, but that depends on your site really. You can check how much of a revenue you're creating with these users, from where they bounce, what is the bounce rate and things like that. You can check how the user is interacting with your content on the landing page, is the bounce rate too high and things like that. You can also look at the exit pages, and what this means is where the user is leaving your website, and if any page has a very high exit percentage, you probably need to work on it and make it more interacting for the user. You can check site speeds. You can check the site speed, the page speeds of all the pages on your site. This line here shows the average load time of a page on your website and whether a particular page is above the average or below. So you can have a look at that, and it also gives you a lot of speed suggestions as for every single page, the number of suggestions you can work on to improve page speed. If you have a search feature on your site, it'll give you an idea of how much user searches on your site and what are the terms they search for. Events is very interesting. So you can create events. Your developer will have to help you out here in creating events on your page, on your website. This is specially required in apps where you create an event for everything that the user does on your app or your website, and you can track them here. So like here we have two events, enhanced e-commerce or contact us. So the user probably have used contact us 171 times in the selected time frame. You can also have a look at events flow, just like we had a look at the flow by pages. Here you can have a look at flow by events. Let's look at publisher. Now this is not connected for this account, but what this means is that if you run a website where you're also advertising using AdSense, you can connect your AdSense account to your Google Analytics account, and then you'll be able to see that what content on your page is getting you most amount of revenue, impressions or clicks, what kind of ads is working for you, what kind of content is working for you. This will give you an idea, overview of your publisher account right here. That's about it for the behavior reports. I hope you've got a good overview of everything, right from audience acquisition to behavior. We'll also talk about conversions in the next video. We'll see how you can create goals as well for your account. If there is anything that I've left out, or if there is any doubt you have, please leave a comment or reach out to me on any of these platforms, and I'll be more than happy to get back to you. Thank you and have a great day.